President Marcos vetoes a bill seeking to expand the franchise area of Aboitiz-owned Davao Light and Power Company, or DLPC. Marcos said he vetoed the measure since it may infringe on the franchise coverage area of the North Electric Cooperative, or NDEC. The bill sought to amend DLPC's 25-year franchise to construct, operate, and maintain a power system in Davao City and in other towns in Davao del Norte. But Marcos said NDEC still has existing franchises in the proposed coverage areas in the bill until 2033. He adds, allowing another power firm in those areas would also be against the Electric Power Industry Reform Act, which states that all existing franchises shall be allowed their full term. A state of calamity declared in the Philippine province of Abra, the epicenter of a deadly earthquake that rocked Luzon Island Wednesday. President Marcos visited Abra and ordered concerned agencies to immediately restore water supply in the area. More from Pia Gutierrez.
A day after a powerful magnitude 7 quake hit Luzon, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. flew to the epicenter Abra to see for himself the situation in the quake-hit province. Once there, Marcos Jr. presided over a situation briefing with local and national officials in the capital, Benguet, where he was updated on the government's rescue and relief efforts. Among the first questions of the president, is it already safe for residents to return to their homes?
Yusek Solidum, are we allowing them already? Are we allowing them already to go back into their homes, to at least the engineers, to inspect if they are safe?
Yes po. Kung declared talagang structurally safe po yung mga building, pwede na. But people should be ready how to respond properly during aftershocks. Kasi malakas pa po ang posibleng aftershock.
Abra has declared a state of emergency, and according to reports, almost 5,000 families or 20,000 individuals in 110 villages in the Ilocos and Cordillera regions have been affected by the quake. Over 2,300 families are still staying at evacuation centers. During the meeting, the president ordered agencies to immediately work on restoring the supply of clean water. The Office of Civil Defense says the entire province of Abra needs some 300,000 bottles of drinking water. Marcos Jr. also called on agencies to expedite the clearing of damaged roads and bridges, as well as to prioritize the safety inspections of hospitals and medical facilities so these can be used immediately.
National government agencies, lahat ng gagawin ninyo, please coordinate closely with the local government para ma-maximize ang inyong mga asset. Hindi kayo nag-uulit, hindi kayo nagkukulang. You plan everything together. You listen to the local governments kasi sila nga, they are the ones who have the fundamental responsibility to bring this aid to our people.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. meanwhile agrees with his sister Senator Aimee Marcos that further strengthening the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council would be enough for government to effectively respond to calamities and disasters without the need to create a separate agency.
May I recommend, rather than a full-scale department na mauubos lang ang budget sa sahod ng limang USEC, sang katutak na ASEC, can we start by an NDRRMC authority or administration tulad ni Apo Lakay, yung DBM nag-umpisa bilang commission?
We are siblings indeed. I fully agree. I did not ever understand the concept of a full department. I don't think it means that because you don't really have to form policy. It is just an implementation of a rescue mission or search and rescue mission.
The president says a good model to follow would be that of the United States Federal Emergency Management Agency, or FEMA, which is an agency under the U.S. Department of Homeland Security.
In our case, perhaps just to prove the point, is simply to put it under the office of the president so that the orders can be issued to different departments because they're primo inter pares, right? So perhaps the best would be that situation under the office of the president, not a mere authority or administration, so that we save on cost.
But on Wednesday, President Marcos Jr. in a briefing said that he supports the passage of a measure creating the Department of Disaster Resilience, as he noted the need for a specialist agency to mitigate disasters brought about by climate change. Meanwhile, in a separate briefing, the DSWD said that residents affected by the powerful earthquake may avail of financial assistance between 5,000 to 10,000 pesos under the assistance to individuals in crisis situation. Families of quake fatalities will also receive burial assistance from the government amounting to 25,000 pesos. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.